Grumpy Red Couch. My name is Tracy and I'm your host, and I have Scouts on the couch for the moment. Who knows how long she'll stay up here, so if you have a chance, pet her while she's here, because she's bound to decide that she wants to go somewhere else, because who knows, because she's a dog and she likes to do what she likes. Anyway, welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. It has been a fast first week of November, and today is one of those days, it's one of those nondescript days where it's not quite sunny, but it's cloudy-ish, but not quite full-on clouds. So we get that bit of a haze happening. So it's one of those nondescript November days, and the chill is in the air. We had snow this past week. I think it's the earliest I've ever seen snow. The earliest before that, I remember November 14th when I was still in university. The snow came down and it didn't leave. So yeah, this was a little bit earlier this year, and a bit of a shock when I woke up on Thursday morning to find that there was snow on the rooftops and on the ground. And yeah, it's just gonna keep coming. Anyway, I know some people like snow. I'm unfortunately not one of them, but it does mean that I have a chance to just sit down, cuddle, put the fireplace on, and do some knitting. Anyway, Scout is just settling there, so get your pets in while you can. And I am here to talk about some knitting that I've gotten up to this week. I have a finished object to share with you as well, so I'm very excited about that. But first, let me tell you where you can find me. I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. And if you are a new viewer to the podcast, welcome. This is a podcast where I primarily chatter away about the knitting that I've gotten up to. This week, it's all about the knitting, so welcome. And if you are a returning viewer, I am so happy to have you back. I know that you've got your spot either on the red chairs or the comfy couch. I know. I wonder sometimes whether I should change the name of the podcast because the couch is now white and not red, but I'm just still not there yet, so maybe some feedback would be great. Anyway, for now, it is the Comfy Red Couch, and welcome. I always love having you here, and I know that you are just snuggling up on whatever November you are experiencing, whether it is cold and chilly because it's fall, or whether it is because it is spring and the flowers are coming out. Whatever November you're dealing with, I know you have your requisite cup of whatever it is you are drinking. Me, it is hot. And you've got your project ready to just sit down and chatter away for a little bit. So let's get settled and let's start with some tea time. And as you saw, I am drinking out of my Haunted Mansion mug. At the very bottom, it says, hurry back. And yes, it's a nice, big, warm cup of tea for a chilling November. And I'm just drinking Marks and Spencer tea. I'm getting down to the very last bits of my bagged Marks and Spencer. I do have some Marks and Spencer loose tea. Plus, I've got a ton of other teas that I've got to get through. So, Marks and Spencer it is today. So, let us say cheers. And what shall we cheer to today? I think we will cheer to all of the holiday knitting that we are going to be doing in the next few weeks, as we do some panic knitting for some of us, as we do some relaxing holiday knitting for others. But here is to all of the holiday knitting that is on the needles. Cheers. I know the Marks and Spencer's Extra Strong Tea is just a basic builder's tea, but it is just so good, and it's got such a great flavor to it. I love it. Anyway, so I put it down for a little bit, and I am ready to chatter away about what I've been working on this week. And this week has been all about the knit vent. So even though I've wanted to sneak in a few projects for myself, there's not time right yet. So first off is something I put on the needles yesterday. And yesterday we went for a little bit of a drive, and I'll talk about that in bits and bobs. But I wound my yarn, grabbed the pattern, made sure I had the correct needles. I forgot to bring a counter with me. So while I'm thinking about it, here is an unused counter, which is going into my Charlie Brown project bag. So always a fun bag, and it's got one of the lovely little baubles on it. When this bauble first came out, it actually had a painted star on either side, but unfortunately it came off. Now this is a project bag, and I'm gonna write down the name of the maker. I know there's lots of D's in there. Designs by. This is Vicky's niece's company. And Vicky used to make bird leg bags. And if you've tuned in before, you know I absolutely love my bird legs bags. So Vicky has given the pattern rights that she used for her bags to her niece. And this is a bag I bought a couple of years ago. And it's kind of fun. It's got some polka dots happening in there as well. So matching the little tag on the side. But who doesn't love a Charlie Brown Christmas? So what is in this project bag? This is Design 3 from KnitVent. And Helen did put spoilers out for yarn. So spoiler alert, maybe. If you don't want to know the yarns that are going to be used for the upcoming advents, I'm going into full on spoiler alert for the next two projects. So I don't think you should run screaming out of the room. I think you should just stay. But just so you know, they're still in spoiler alert mode. Okay? So, and I'm starting off with pattern 3, not 2. Just because. And for pattern 3, it is a DK weight yarn, and I am using Nora George yarns, and this is the colorway Great White. And it is a lovely blue speckled yarn. This is yarn that Nathaniel chose yesterday morning before we went on our car ride and got it all wound up. And again, forgot the counter. I did cast on and did a tiny little bit, but then I didn't want to lose count, so I stopped. I probably should have stuck with this project because the other project I worked on yesterday, it was one of those Murphy's Laws projects. But anyway, this is Great White DK, and this project is going to be released this upcoming Thursday. So as you can see, this is a pretty big cake of yarn. I've got a lot of knitting to do. But it is for Nathaniel, which means it will be a little bit of a smaller object, which is good. And I do have tomorrow off, which is nice, and I think I'll get a good chunk of this done in the next couple of days. I don't think it'll be a long knit. I think this will be a relatively quick knit, and as I said, I am making it for Nathaniel, so it will be appropriately sized for a 10-year-old, which is good. So anyway, that is one of the projects that I started yesterday but didn't get too far on. The other project that I am going to share with you, last week I talked a little bit about it, and I said that it didn't have a project bag at the time because it was living on the knitting table and I was keeping things sorted. It's gotten, and I shouldn't say it's a temporary project bag because it's now just moved in, but and I used it not too long ago, I solemnly swear that I am up to no good bag was on the table, and it was a good size. I grabbed it, and that is what this project is now living in, and it is now attached to some yarn. which I've put off to the side because I'm going to talk a little bit about this project. And again, spoiler, spoiler, this is Knit Vent 2. And this week, Knit Vent 2 and Knit Vent 3 are both being released on the same day. So I have been working on this one for a little over a week now. And as I said, I picked up the other one yesterday. I will have them both done. But the way I was working yesterday, I will get them both done. Anyway, this is where the project is currently living because it needed to be transported a few days. Now this is, as I said, a bit of a spoiler, the project where you can have a lot of flexibility, a lot of freedom. You can use whatever yarns you want. And I am using a fingering weight set. I'm going to say sets of yarns. And this is a great project for using either an advent calendar, minis that you have, scraps of yarn or bits of yarn, whatever you want to call them. And so this is a really fun and flexible project. I know Deb, who is Tink Hickman, has used for her test knit, she has used 10 gram minis of a 24 10 gram mini. So she's gone with a 10 gram advent kit. I have gone with mini sets. And what I'm using are some Nora George mini sets that are all great characters of literature. So I started off with this set, and this is the Midsummer Night's Dream. And there's going to be crinkling. And these are the minis that I used for the Midsummer Night's Dream. And I have to tell you, this one here called Fairies was absolutely magical to wind and magical to work with. And it's got these gorgeous pinks, purples, and bits of orange and yellow, and I'm throwing minis around now. I just loved this one. And the whole set of minis for Midsummer Night's Dream was fun. And as you can tell, I used different amounts of each mini. And that's because I have a thing for symmetry, and this pattern is something you can play around with a bit. You can either just knit straight till you run out of your minis, or you can set things up the way you want. I've set things up the way I want because I like predictability, I like symmetry. So my yarn minis that are left over are a little bit uneven looking now, but that's because my project is going to look very even looking when it's done. So, Midsummer Night's Dream was the first set of minis that I used. The second set of minis that I used is from Emma, right there, Emma. And again, five more minis, and whoops, I'm just throwing the minis all around. So a variety of colors, some pinks, some greens, a bit of brown, some white with speckles and purple, and just nice as I continue to drop minis everywhere. And I'll have to pop a picture of what all of the three mini sets looked like in a row. So I'll pop that in so you can see them before I started winding them, although I think one is wound at the end. So right now I have Midsummer Night's Dream and Emma, and I'm going for very soft tones. We've got lots of pinks, blues, lots of creams, lots and lots of speckles. And the final one that I'm using, and I'm attached to some yarn right now, is the Peter Rabbit set, and or the Beatrice Potter set. And there was an actual full-size Peter Rabbit skein, but these are all the characters from Beatrix Potter classics. So I am currently knitting with this gorgeous purple, and I must really, really love this purple because I have had to knit and tink and knit and tink, and I have knit the same spot 3 times because I keep making a really stupid mistake. And it's a really easy pattern, but when we were driving yesterday, I made a mistake, and then I guess I got distracted at one point and made another mistake and then dropped some stitches, so then I had to go back, and oh my goodness. I must love this because I've been stuck on this mini for 2 days now. I'll be done very, very soon. Crossing fingers. Anyway, I have to tell you, on Friday, I was really hoping that I could use my lunch hour to get a good chunk of knitting done. And as a hopeful gesture, I wound this mini. Well, then of course, Murphy's Law says, if you wind an extra mini, you're never going to get to it when you think you're going to get to it. So don't wind the minis before you get to them. Just wind them as you go, because otherwise you're going to have things pop up. So Friday night, I knew that we were going for a couple hours in the car, and I knew that I was going to be at an event where I'd have a chance to do some knitting. What did I do? I wound all of my minis. Hello, Murphy's Law, minis. Did I get to any of these? Obviously not, because they're all still in the bag. I'm still working on the first one. I should have known better, especially after Friday. I should have known better, but I just wanted to wind them all up. So the next one in my project, so I'm in purple now. My next one is going to be this lovely yellow, and I'm going in the order that Tracy had them ordered in the packages. The next one is going to be this white one. It almost looks Americana, and this one I think is Benjamin Bunny. This is the squirrel. I don't know the names off the top of my head right now. This green is absolutely lovely. And the green is Jeremy Fisher. So the purple is the Tailor of Gloucester. The yellow is Squirrel Nutkin. The one that I said kind of looks Americana is Benjamin Bunny. Jeremy Fisher is this green, and the last one is Jemima Puddle Duck. And I know this one because when I was winding it, I just thought it looked like candy cane on crack, or not candy cane, candy floss on crack. And oh my goodness, it was fun to wind, and I just can't wait to start knitting this one because it's going to be fun. It's just a nice soft pink, and it's got highlights of bright yellow and red and purple and blue, and just, it's like candy floss on crack. That's the only way I can describe Jemima Puddle Duck. So, like, look at those fun pops of color. So my goal today and tomorrow is to get all of these minis knit up and get this project off the needles. Crinkle, crinkle, crinkle. In fact, I'm going to put those minis there. I'm going to wind this back up, and I'm going to pop it into my I Solemnly Swear That I Am Up to No Good by Sweet Sparrow Handmade bags. So, crinkle, crinkle, and more crinkles happening. Anyway, those are the two knit vents that I am working on and will be working on for the next couple of days. One will be a very quick knit. The other one should be fairly quick going the rest of the way if I don't continue to make really dumb mistakes. And they're just, that's what they are. They're just my brain goes off on its own little hiatus. It's fantastic TV knitting, as long as you, you know, just remember to pay a little bit of attention to it. Anyway, I'll get it done. And I'm looking forward to sharing that those both with you next week. But for now, I get to share this week's KnitVent release, which is the first pattern that was released this past Thursday. And it had been living in my Bird Legs bag, special Christmas bag. And I will just quickly share my yarns with you again. And I did share these last week. I also used these yarns to make my little coffee cardigan holders. So the first color that I used was this gorgeous ivory. And these are all Juniper Moon Farm, not plural, yarns. And they are wool, alpaca, and silk as a nice blend. They are squishy, and this is a worsted weight yarn. Now, the project that Helen did was a heavier weight yarn, but I had this in my stash and I really thought it would look neat. So this is the first color that I used. The second color I used, and this one is called Cotton Candy. So it's instead of my pink cotton candy on crack that is just over there, this is the blue cotton candy. This one is called Swimming Pool, and that's where I was yesterday, and I'll share about that in bits and bobs. I love this blue. And the last color I used, and I don't have much left, is charcoal. And the project, the Bide shawl that I'm going to share with you in a moment, Helen has put tassels on. And I didn't have enough of the charcoal to make tassels, but what I'm thinking I might do, we'll see, is I might hold my yarns together so that I've got all of the colors. I've got a doubling of the charcoal happening here, and maybe make some multicolored tassels with the yarn. So something I'm thinking about. I just need to make the time to do it. And but I think that'd be kind of fun to have multicolored tassels on the ends, just on the two ends of the shawl. I am throwing yarn around like it's going out of style today. Anyway, these are the four colors that I used for my Bide shawl. I'll pop those back in the bag. And let me show you my Bide shawl. So, as I said, Helen used a heavier weight yarn and she also used one color, but I decided that I wanted to use yarn from stash, and I really liked the idea of playing with color. And even though I used worsted weight yarn, it's actually a pretty good size, like a bib right now. It's a pretty good size shawl, and I mean, from the middle along the spine, I did measure it. It's about 24 inches, although I'm pulling it now, and I think it was 68 inches for the wingspan. It's basically, if I really, really stretch, I can hold both ends, but it's a bit, yeah. It's a good wingspan. And yeah, it's just a nice cozy shawl. It's very soft, and I do love how the colors have worked with this pattern. And what I did was, just before I got to each of the eyelet sections, the knit row before the garter ridge, I changed my color there. So I changed my color on the right side so that I would have a nice effect with the garter coming up, and it also helped with weaving in ends. Are you going away? And then before I got to the next eyelet section, I changed my color, and then when I got to the last one, I changed my color. And I used pretty much the entire skein, as you could see from what I had left over from this last eyelet change to the end of the shawl. It is written as per the large instructions, so I haven't removed or added any extra garter rows here, and I am quite pleased with this shawl. It's very, very cozy. Now, I believe it is going to be a gift. All I need to do now is to decide whether I'm going to make those multicolored tassels. I think that would be kind of fun, and I just want to put them on the ends, not in the center there. So that is, I think I probably will do it. I just need to make the time to do it. So maybe once I finish the two knit vents for this week, I will do that. So this is the Bide shawl, and that was the first pattern from Knitvent 2019, and that is just nice to be able to finally share something with you, because I've had so many secret knits that I've been working on. And I do have a couple more secret knits that are completely done that I am waiting to share with you when I am given the go-ahead on those. I think one will be probably December 1st will be released, or November 30th. And the other one I think might come out in the next week, so I might be able to share that with you next week. Crossing fingers, I'm hoping. And of course, I will also have the two knitvent projects that I am working on this week right now that I will be able to share with you as well next week. So next week's going to be some finished objects, which will be nice. And that is all that I have for sharing of projects. I do not have any brown paper packages, though I am expecting a couple things in the mail. But I do want to remind you about the lovely little contest that we have going on. And that is just a little chatter happening in the Comfy Red Couch Ravelry group. And all I've asked is for you to share what your favorite project you've ever worked on is. And it's just a chatter thread. So what I'm going to do is I am going to just draw from the chatter that's happening. So it might be an actual just chatter, hey, that was a great project you put up there. Or it might be a picture of, this is my favorite project because. All I know is it's just nice to share those things that we love. And what I ended up sharing on that chatter thread was a crocheted item that I made several years ago, and that was the old rose wrap. And I'll need to bring it down and share it with you, because it's something I may have shared it a long time ago, but it's just, I think it's one of the most spectacular projects, it's one of the best patterns out there. It's a really flexible pattern. So I'll need to remember to bring it down from the cedar chest and share it with you at some point. So that's the project I shared, and we've had a couple of people share some projects. I would love to have some more people join in the group. And the prize for joining in the group is a lovely print that Lorna, who is Never at a Loose End, has sent, and it was done by her daughter, Ailey. And that is the All Wool is Yarn, but Not All Yarn is Wool poster. I think I got it right this week. And it's got yaks and llamas, or is that an alpaca? And there's a llama, or there's a goat. Get all my animals all mixed up. A sheep, of course, and an angora rabbit. I don't know if it's an alpaca or a llama. I think it's an alpaca. They're very similar. But anyway, that is the poster that you can win. And because I've been working solidly on Knitvent, there is also a coffee cup cardigan that will have cute little flamingo buttons that I still have to finish, but I'll have it done for next week. And so there's another finished object for next week. So coffee cup cardigan, a lovely print, and then there's going to be some lovely Sloan tea sachets in the heavenly cream flavor that will go in that little prize pack. So just a nice little November, early December treat. So come on over to the Comfy Red Couch Ravelry group and share your favorite project that you've worked on, share in the discussion, And I will do that draw next week. So you have until the, I think it's the 14th at 9 Eastern Standard Time. And then I'm going to close that thread and I will pick from, I think I'm going to have Siri pick. I hope she doesn't pick one of my comments though, because that'll just be, because I'm commenting in there too. So I won't win. I know that. That's good. I already have a print and I can make my own coffee cup cardigans and oh, I could easily buy Sloan tea, but not everybody can. It is so fantastic. Anyway, that is what is happening. Those are my finished objects. I have no brown paper packages to share. So let's just get to some bits and bobs chatter. I am beyond excited right now. Now, I didn't lie when I filmed the podcast a little bit earlier. I had no brown paper packages this week. And as I was editing the podcast, just upstairs, I looked out the window and I saw the Canada Post delivery truck, which means now we are going into the holiday season, Sunday delivery from Canada Post. And so I kind of dropped everything upstairs and ran downstairs and put my shoes on and stalked the mailman, which was good because he dropped off a very heavy package for me. It's really heavy. I thought it was one thing and then I realized it's something else. But oh my goodness, I am so, so excited to share this with you. And it's really taped up well. So I think we're going to have some fun. Maybe I need some scissors. I might be wise to get scissors. But I'm stubborn. I like to be able to rip the tape off. But you know what? I'm going to grab some scissors. I know I'm excited, but I will tell you, I did not run with the scissors. I wanted to, but I didn't do it. Anyway, I ordered this amazing parcel, I think last week, and I came across this on Instagram because that's where you come across these wonderful, wonderful things. And I've been wanting to do some more sewing as I'm trying to cut without hurting myself or damaging anything. I've been wanting to do some more sewing, and so I came across these neat little items that I'm going to share with you in a few moments once I figure out how to open the package. Oh my goodness, packing tape is dangerous. I love Sunday delivery from Canada Post. It's just the most exciting time of the year. I tried to look up online a little bit earlier today when it would be starting, and this is a complicated box, and I wasn't able to discover when it was going to be starting, so I was quite pleased to look out and discover today that it has started. It has indeed. And my goodness, maybe I should just like fast forward through the opening of this package. This is a complicated box. It's really, really complicated. It's got some sort of middle opening. This was a very complicated box. I had to finally get to the tops, and it's like two boxes in one. You want to know what it is too, don't you, Scout? There's like a couple boxes in here. So, wait till I show you what I have. So, the package is from Foxglove and Field. And if you have seen Foxglove and Field on Instagram, they are pattern weights. And they are gorgeous, gorgeous pattern weights. Goodness. I ordered gift wrapping. And they are so prettily wrapped. Oh, so excited. They're very heavy. And oh my goodness. Oh, they are just so beautifully wrapped and heavy. And another one. I had these wrapped for Christmas to put under the tree. And I'm going to be really awful right now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put up a photograph of what it is that I have purchased, because I am going to put these gorgeous little parcels under the tree for myself for Christmas. So at least I have something to open. I am so excited to share these with you. So I will put a picture of what I've purchased so you can see what they are. And what they are they look like an old style spool of thread. And so they've got like a wooden, the old wooden spools of thread, and they are wrapped in a gorgeous Liberty print. And they are heavy weight, so exercise. And there's two different size weights. So this is the bigger size one, and I've got one in here. And then this one has three of the heavier size weights, and they come in a beautiful box inside. And these are two sets of the smaller weights. And what you do is you put them on your pattern and then you cut your pattern. So I'm hoping to do some sewing. So while I'm not going to share and open these up yet, I will put a spoiler photo so you can see what I'm getting for Christmas. And oh my goodness, Sunday delivery, so happy. Anyway, that is what I ordered from Foxglove and Field. And as I said, there is Foxglove and Field, beautiful, lovely with the Liberty prints, and there's other prints as well, but I went all Liberty. So anyway, I will put some photos and you can see what I spoiled myself with for Christmas this year. So there's a brown paper package, last minute. Who would have thought? So we are now going to go back to the Bits and Bobs, which is filmed before I received this brown paper package. And so it's a little bit discombobulated, but that's okay. Sunday mail is always a great thing to throw in last minute. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And it's November. It is definitely November. I was in shock this week when we had snow. And I know there are lots of parts of Canada that get snow in the end of October. And, you know, once it snows in November, it's on the ground until April, May. I'm thankful that I don't live in a climate quite as snowy as that. So Toronto, we usually get a little bit of snow in November, like a dusting, but it usually goes away. And then, you know, December, we have lots of bare ground and then we get some snow. And then once Christmases past, we often get the snow and it stays until March. And so sometimes it comes a little bit earlier, sometimes it comes a little bit later. Global warming, it changes, who knows. One year, I do remember it snowed November 14th, and this is when I was living at home with my parents still. It snowed November 14th, and that was it. It stayed on the ground, but they do live a little bit east of Toronto. I think Toronto, if you came into the city, it wasn't as bad. So, but yeah, November 14th was the earliest I remember getting snow before. So this past week, getting it before the 14th was a bit of a shock for me when I looked out the window. What is this white stuff? And it was a crazy day because the snow on the ground, and then there was some sort of problem on the transit system. So when I dropped Nathaniel off at school and went for the normal right-hand turn, there were a lot of people around, and I thought, why are there so many people around? It's a lot, you know, I know I'm a couple minutes later than I normally am, but this doesn't look normal. I wondered if they were doing a film shoot. They do lots of movies, so I thought maybe they were doing a movie shoot. But no, what it was there was a stretch of the subway that was closed down, and there were people that were just walking because waiting for the shuttle buses takes forever. And my normal 7-minute commute to work took me about a half an hour. And at one of the major roads, instead of the people waiting on the sidewalk, I guess there had been so many people that they had to get off the subway there. There was no more room on the sidewalk and they weren't going to walk. They were just waiting for the shuttle buses. They were all on the road. Well, if you're standing on the road, the buses can't come because no traffic's moving. So it was just the strangest thing to see all the people on the road blocking the traffic. And yeah, it was, and then a lot of people walking. It was a very, you know, as soon as I turned, I knew something was off. And I did see a shuttle bus going the other way, but we were going against the flow of traffic. And we, like I said, it took me a half an hour, which normally takes me 7 minutes from door to door. But yeah, it was quite the commute. And with a light dusting of snow. So yes, it was definitely interesting. So that was my Thursday. Yesterday, oh my goodness, yesterday we had a fun family day. And I did talk about, I wound up some yarn thinking I was going to have a couple of hours in the car. And Toronto traffic on a Saturday is usually pretty busy, but yesterday it was fabulous. It flew along, and it took us an hour and a half to get to St. Catharines, which is near, actually we went to Niagara Falls. And so I was going to say near Niagara Falls, but we actually did go to Niagara Falls, and we went to a water park in Niagara Falls for my nephew's birthday, and we had a fun birthday party with my niece and my two nephews and Nathaniel. Unfortunately, Isaac is in school, in college, so he was not able to join us, but I had a lovely day with my brother-in-law and my sister-in-law, and I actually went in the pool, although I do have to say my favorite part was the hot tub. I liked the hot tub a lot, and I found a perfect jet, and I just put my hands against the jet to wiggle out those, you know, when you're knitting, you need to wiggle out those fingers. So yeah, I'm sticking my hands against the jets, and oh, it was lovely. And it was kind of interesting because this indoor water park is at a hotel, and normally it is apparently very, very busy, but they had a billiards tournament happening, and so the whole hotel was booked out with all of these people who were there to play billiards. So while we were having our pool party, there were other people in the hotel having a completely different pool party, and you could tell that they were really into it because they were carrying around their own little cases with their own pool cues and or billiard cues, whatever you want to call them. But yeah, it was really interesting to see these groups of people. One guy was wearing a Hawaiian shirt that had the billiard balls with the numbers on them, or the pool balls, whatever you want to call them. And so they were taking up residence in the hotel, which was fantastic for us because it meant that there were a lot less people in the water park. So when I would get in the hot tub, there would only be like one or two other people, which was great. I do have to say there was a guy that was in the water park in a Speedo that was a bit... Don't wear Speedos, and don't wear Speedos to water parks where there are wave pools and water slides. Just, it's a dangerous thing. I, of course, had my bathing suit on, and then I had my water shorts over top and my rash guard on. I was fully covered because, yeah. It was November, and it was winterish, and I was in a pool, so yeah, I like to wear the rash guard and the shorts over top of my bathing suit. So it was kind of fun though, because my shorts would sort of blow up while I was in the spa. I did go down the water slide once, and that was fun, but the water was cold in the regular pool. And I don't know that the wave pool was a bit too wavy for me. It made me feel like I was on I've never been on a cruise ship, but it made me feel like that's what a cruise ship would feel like. But it was a really, really fun day. And afterwards, we went across the border to my sister and brother-in-law's place. And we always have such a lovely time with them. And so it was just a really, really fun day. Although, I don't think I got very far on my project because I was making really great progress in the car, and then I looked and I realized I had made some weird error and I wasn't sure what I had done, and it wasn't an easy drop down fix. So I started thinking back and basically unknit all of what I had done in the car. And then when we were in the water park, we had a cabana, which was kind of fun, so I was able to sit and do a bit of knitting while the kids were swimming and while I sort of steeled myself to go into the water. And I knit, and then I did another silly mistake and then had to tink back again because I couldn't quite figure out what I had done. So I just was, there's really one row I knit 3 times, but I'm now past that row, and hopefully, knock on wood, that woke Scout up. Did that wake you up, my knocking on wood? Anyway, I hope I am past that, and I've got the brain power to finish off. It's not a brain taxing project, but it just, I don't know. It'll get done. Anyway, I was able to work on that yesterday, which was a lot of fun. And, but yeah, I must really love this mini because I've spent a lot of time knitting and unknitting it. Anyway, that was our lovely, lovely Saturday. I also stopped at a bakery in Niagara Falls that my wonderful coworker, his family owns that. So I stopped in and got some treats, and I left some treats at my lovely sister and brother-in-law's, and apparently they were very much liked those treats, and I have some here today. So I did have a half of a cannoli this morning, and I have some lovely Napoleons. I love Napoleons, so I do have some of those, and I'm going to eat a Napoleon after I finish podcasting today, so I'm looking forward to that with some more tea. And I think that's all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs this week. Scout has popped back up to say goodbye. I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead, filled with lots of happy crafting time. And whether you are working on gifts for other people for the holiday season, or whether you are working on some things for yourself, or whether, like me, you're doing some test knitting, whatever you're doing, I am wishing you just a lot of peace while you're working on it, and joy and happiness, because that's always nice when you can work on a project and you have those nice calm feelings. So I'm wishing that for you. And I hope that your week ahead is filled with lots of treats. I've got some treats in the fridge, my Napoleon, that I'm going to get into. And I hope to see you next week. So all the best in the week ahead. And I'm excited to share a couple of projects with you next week, the ones that I've been working on this week. So I will hopefully see you then, and wishing you all the best until then. Bye. I wound the most amazing, amazing mini. And this is Nora George Fairies. And I was thinking to myself how amazing it would be to have a sweater's quantity of this. But at this moment, all I have left is this little tiny bit of yarn. Perhaps enough to knit a sweater for a fairy. I wonder what size needles I would have to use. Maybe just a regular needle. That would be really a challenge to knit a fairy sweater with, wouldn't it? But oh my goodness. Look at that gorgeousness.